Welcome back. So today we're going to change the oil on my S4, which will go for pretty much any 3.0T. The process is very similar no matter what car you have. So let's get into it.
What you're going to need for this car is some 5W40. Now they make green bottles as well. Those typically have like a lubricant in it that helps with engine wear.
I bought this ECS magnetic drain plug. I'll link this in the description, but I'm going to be putting this in today and then we'll see what happens next time I change my oil if there's anything on this. I think this was like only like $6 or $7, so totally worth it. Okay, so first thing we're gonna do is jack the car up. If you haven't been driving your car, the engine's not warm. You wanna make sure that the engine is warm and the oil is up to temperature when you're draining it. And then I just like to take the mat and slide it back underneath the car. That'll work. All right, next you're gonna take an Allen key. I honestly don't remember what size it is, but if you have a set, you can just trial and error until you get which one's right. And then you're gonna loosen that oil drain plug that I just showed you. I've got this green, I think you can buy the, I don't know, for their 20 quart buckets that you can buy at like pretty much any auto parts store. I think they're like $10 to $20, so they're not too bad. What I like to do is I'll crack that first, pull the plug aside, and then go up to the top and open up the oil cap so that it flows. If you open the oil cap first and then drop the plug, as soon as the plug starts to come out, a ton of oil starts spewing out, so it just makes a mess everywhere. It's gonna be a mess no matter what, but it makes it even worse.
Since I'm not gonna be using that plug again anyway, might as well just throw it away.
Fun fact, this bubble wrap that I got when I bought the diffuser for this car has been one of the like best underneath the car cardboard style things to lay on. It's super slippery with your clothes. It's soft on your back or your head. So it's like a 2-for-1 when you buy it. Okay, while that's draining, we're gonna go ahead and pull the fuel filter off, or the oil filter off, and change that out. Now you're gonna want at least like a rag or an oil dedicated rag or some sort of paper towels, because pulling the filter out usually makes a little bit of a mess. All right, once you get this out, you literally pull the filter just straight off. I'll show you what I mean when I put the new one back on. And then there's a, I'll see if I can show you. Yep, you see that little tab kind of right there on the right side sticking out. There's a little rubber ring in here. If you take a 90 degree pick or a hook pick, I find it's the easiest to grab. And you just kind of pinch it up against the wall and pull up this little rubber ring. You're just gonna pull that guy out as well and throw it away. Now I usually buy man filters, but all the stores that I was going to, they were out of them. So I just ran to my local Audi dealer and picked up a OEM one, Volkswagen Group. But it should come with the filter and that ring that we just took out. So it doesn't really matter which way the filter goes on. It's just gonna slide over that middle piece. And then in here, typically they'll come with this right here. There's two rings actually, yeah, and I forgot. I'll show you where the second one's at. Just grab your pick and it comes right off as well. Okay, now that you got both of those filter cap, filter housing, just take some of your new oil, put it on your fingers, lube these up, and then just put them back in the way you took them out. This one obviously doesn't matter. This one, just make sure the tab is facing up, so when you go to do your oil change next time, you can do the same thing with the pick, pull it right out. It makes your life a lot easier. All right, so we went ahead and we lubed up the two rubber fittings. All I did was stick my finger inside of there and then just basically run it through my fingers, put it inside the cap, put it around the housing. Then you're gonna take your new filter and you're just gonna slide it over top. And you'll hear it click. There you go. And then it shouldn't be able to fall off. So we can now take this and we're going to just put it back into the filter housing. And then on the top of this lid, it says 25.5 Newton meters. So we'll take our torque wrench and torque it to 25.5 Newton meters. Okay, so first I'd like to just get it on so that I'm threading it with my hand first, so I know I'm not stripping it or ruining it. And eventually it'll get to the point where you can't really use it. Use your fingers to tighten it. And then we'll set our torque wrench to 25.5. If you have this car and you're gonna do your own oil changes, yes, over the life of you owning it, it's probably gonna be cheaper if you do it yourself. And if you invest in a few simple tools, this is one of them. It's a specialty socket. It's a 36 millimeter socket. this is what you need for that oil filter cap. Another thing, anything you do with a car, technically you should probably have a torque wrench. And you can literally buy them on Amazon. So you could find one on Amazon probably for 30 bucks. Okay, now that the oil is done draining and we put the new oil filter in, I'm gonna take this ECS drain plug, this magnetic drain plug, and then screw this guy in, and it's gonna go till snug and a quarter, maybe a half turn, and then we'll go ahead and fill it up with oil. When we fill it up with oil, we're gonna drop the car back to the ground so that it's level, and then I think it's 6.8 quarts. Okay, now we got the drain plug put back in, cleaned up the area, and like I said, we're just gonna do like a half a turn after you get it snug. Right there, should do it. Now, to save you a little bit of headache, don't put the belly pan back on yet. Wait till you fill the car up, start running it. That way you can see if there's any leaks, if you need to tighten that drain plug a little bit more. Then if that's the case, jack the car back up, put the belly pan back on. Sometimes you create more work for yourself, which obviously I have done before. So usually what I do is I'll put 6.8 quarts in it and then drive it around. Once it's able to give me a reading with the electronic dipstick, I'll just add accordingly. It's never been an issue, and I've done, I think, 8 oil changes now with this car, and it's about to be, I think we're about to click 160,000 miles. Just a tip for you guys, if you are pouring this and you've never done an oil change before, you don't want to pour it this way. It's going to gurgle kind of on you and pulsate, and that's what makes a mess typically when people are trying to fill their car with oil. Instead, take the bottle and gently pour sideways, so it's basically like flat. It allows more air into the bottle, and then just find where that sweet spot is so that it's not kind of jolting out of the tip here, and generally you're not going to make a mess. Or get a funnel, that will make it a little bit easier, but these cars are super simple to do without a funnel. But one last little quick tip for you guys. So if you use these and you do it the way I do, I just go buy 2 of these typically. Generally you're going to have obviously some leftover because it's not going to take 10.5 quarts. It takes about 6.8. But on these bottles, they have these tick marks here. So you see these tick marks along the bottle. So this is 5.2 quarts. 1 quart, 2 quart, 3 quarts, 4 quarts. So it's very easy for you to see how much you have left or how much you put in, and you kind of just eyeball it out. Then once the car actually gets warmed up and the oil's in it, it'll eventually give you a reading on that electronic dipstick, and then you can just add accordingly or leave it the way it is. Okay, I let the car run for about 5 minutes. We look nice and dry up underneath here. There were no oil leaks or oil dripping out of there, so we'll go ahead and button up the belly pan and we're done with the oil change. Now, I have not made a video in a couple weeks for a few reasons. This is for if anybody actually cares. As you may have been able to see, I have a 2G GSX that I bought. There's quite a bit of a story behind this car. Right now, it's just been a lot of troubleshooting getting it back to healthy running order. The car does run, it does drive. I've drove it a little bit. We're in the middle of tuning it and just kind of going through a couple kinks and issues and flaws that it has. That way I can just confidently and reliably drive it. It is pretty a pretty cool story. Get into that further and deeper another day. Long story short, I believe it's 2.3 liter stroker engine. It's got a 70 millimeter Garrett turbo on it, and it's somewhere in that 600 to 700 horsepower range. It is super exhilarating to drive, and I cannot wait to be able to bring you guys into that more so and let you experience a little bit of what I'm experiencing with this car. On top of that one, because I have problems. No, there's another story with this car too. This is the forgotten Porsche. This is a 1974 Porsche 914 that I had as my very first car when I was 15 years old. It got lost for about a decade. It somehow got found, and now I'm gonna be restoring it. So if any of that stuff interests you guys, follow along. I will put a series on that car and a series on this car and try to be a little more consistent with it. But hopefully this video is helpful for those of you that want to change your own oil, save yourself some money, and learn a new skill. Until next time, I'll see you later.